Hi, my name is Ram Devkota. I'm 30 year old. I'm born in Nepal and came over here 2014 in the United States.
When I first met Ram, he was in the intensive care unit in severe end-stage heart failure.
So what we learned was that Mr. Devkota has something called end-stage or burnt-out hypertrophic cardiomyopathy. Hypertrophic cardiomyopathy is a genetic inherited condition that oftentimes results in the heart muscle getting very thick and very stiff.
I don't think he had a way out of the hospital that would prolong his survival unless he got an LVAD. Left ventricular assist device, or LVAD, is a mechanical heart pump. It's surgically implanted into the left ventricle, which is the main pumping chamber of the heart that pumps to the rest of the body. So it kind of takes over for the failing pumping chamber.
And there's wires that come out from the pump, and the wires come out through the abdomen, which are connected to a controller or a little computer, and that little computer needs to be connected to a power source.
LVADs have really been a great medical resource for us because hearts available for transplant are not readily available. There's not that many of them, so when patients are very sick, you really need to support their heart in that acute setting. What we've done here at Yale certainly is we've built a really remarkable LVAD program, which is one of the highest volume and best quality centers in New England.
We think about so many different things when we're trying to evaluate somebody for a heart transplant or left ventricular assist device implant. Medical things, but then a lot of social things as well. When we first met Mr. Devkota, we knew that he was very sick and he was quite young, and there were many of us that wanted to think about what we could do to try to help somebody like this over the long term. Things that were of concern to us that were probably of concern to the other center where he was evaluated prior to seeing us was, one, he did have this issue with alcohol dependence, but secondly, he didn't have a whole lot of social support.
So when I came over here, I'm alone. I have, the habit, after work I need to drink every day.
That LVAD pump was the solution to his heart failure. We knew that. But you don't want to put a pump in someone who isn't going to be successful with it. You do more harm than good. So how could we get him to the point where he's going to be successful with his therapy? And that's where all the other members of the team come in.
We assess the patient for more than just the medical piece. We look at the psychosocial whole. For Ram, it was just kind of taking care of the basics first. Where was he going to live? How was he going to support himself? Helping him deal with his substance use so that he was able to support himself to some degree, because he really had limited other supports.
After LVAD, I feel like it's normal, Same like you. Like other people, this is the miracle. This is my, the second life.
From the moment he was feeling better, that exact moment he started kind of working on everything himself. So he had a lot of drive and initiative, and that's amazing.
He was able to feel good enough physically that he started to feel good enough mentally.
We don't just take the perfect cookie cutter candidates, we really try and work with anyone who needs us to really make them into a good candidate.
As we were taking care of him after his LVAD and he was following up with appointments, he was following up with his addiction services, he was taking all of his medications, he was doing everything, he was like the perfect patient. We're like, oh wow, he would be really successful with a transplant.
I'm in the list, transplant list. Yeah, I have a big thinking. So after the transplant is success, and then I'm you know, the back to normal. I get married. My girlfriend is waiting for me.
It takes a village to be able to offer these therapies to our patients. And our team works really closely together. We're always talking to one another, and we're always thinking creatively for how can we expand access to these therapies to the patients who need them, and in a way that they can derive the most benefit.
There's very few things in medicine that can take people who are essentially have days to live, and you give them a therapy that can keep them alive for decades.
To help that person, and then when they come back and you see them in the future and they look like any other person out there on the street, it's an amazing thing. It really is.